Hello, good morning everyone. My name is Nils, I'm with Auki Labs. I'm in today from Hong Kong, where we are based. China, of course, being the open source epicenter of robotics. And I'm here to talk a little bit about what we call the Great Reversal, a moment in history that I think is very impactful. Now, for thousands of years, humans have created and disappeared into worlds made up of language and art. Starting with stories we told around the campfire, unbroken oral traditions reaching back thousands of years to the invention of writing and the printing press and the mass distribution of novels that would carry us away in our imagination, to misspent youth, late nights in front of computer games that put us in the center of the action, and of course, the culmination of the hard work of the people in this room, fully immersive VR experiences where we can just go disappear, be human beings in a digital world. I submit to you, this is kind of what makes us human, actually. We use language to manifest our knowledge and imagination in the minds of others so that we can think together, experience together, solve problems together. In fact, I submit to you that augmented reality is actually humanity's oldest technological undertaking. AR is the longest running tech tree we've been developing. Let me explain. I want you to imagine that we were walking together through a dense, majestic forest, having a nice time, and we come across this fallen tree. I stop, I point at the tree, and I say, "Hey guys, look at this beautiful couch." The moment I describe the utility of the object, and I call it a couch, something happens in our shared perception. Language is perception-altering technology. You now see that we could sit here. You see the sittingness of the tree. This is what language is for. Language allows us to manifest our knowledge and imagination in the minds of others so that we can have intersubjective experiences, so that we can be intercognitive together. Humanity is the great intercognitive computer, a network of minds connected together by shared languages, shared culture. Together, we form families, startups, empires. Humanity is the great intercognitive computer. And for decades, we have been meeting each other and disappearing into these digital worlds, portaled through our rectangular screens. So what is this great reversal that I want to talk to you guys about today? The great reversal is digital beings joining us here in the physical world. Rather than humans disappearing into the digital is being bridged into the physical. And the spatial computing industry, the people in this room, we are all finding ourselves at the epicenter of what I believe is a pivotal moment in the history of life and language and the universe itself. Spatial computing is making the physical world accessible to AI. This is meaningful because, according to the World Bank, some 70% of the world economy is still tied to physical locations and physical labor, where AI cannot help us today because AI cannot perceive the physical world, it cannot interact with the physical world. So even though AI has had this meteoric, triumphant rise, it's very obvious to those of us in this room that we've barely just scratched the surface. AI will not have its full culmination until we teach it to understand the physical world. This sentiment, of course, famously echoed by Jensen Huang of NVIDIA earlier this year when he took to the CES stage and said, great, we have generative AI now, that's cool. Agentic AI is coming, that's cool. But the next and final frontier of AI is physical AI that understands physical space, understands physics. And a couple of weeks ago, Auki just closed our first multi-million dollar client in retail. Thank you very much. And what we provided is not what I suspect that you suspect we delivered. So this Nordic retailer is rolling out our XR solutions into over 1,000 stores now. And it isn't AR navigation. And it isn't AR advertising. What it is the ability to, using the phones that you already have in your pocket, using spatial computing, AR kit, AR core, all the tools that we're familiar with, help them run the store better. Together, we figured out that you can use spatial computing to make the physical store accessible to AI. Here is a little demo of a supermarket that was collaboratively reconstructed using the RGB feeds, just the RGB feeds, no LiDAR input data, from a group of phones walking around the store filming. So reconstructed just from RGB and IMU, no LiDAR input data. And once you have captured the shape of the store like this, it gets spatio-semantically compressed into something simple like this. These little white squares you see next to the shelves are, believe it or not, QR codes. Lots of them. Who thought that retailers would be willing to place literally millions of QR codes across their stores? Well, they are, once you figure out what the use case is for spatial computing. So what did we do? We made it possible for the local store staff, while they're doing their everyday tasks, to maintain a very simple digital twin of where their products are. Using just an iPhone and a built-in or external barcode scanner, they can create the simple spatial semantic representation of where the shelves are, which of course allows for AR navigation, not for the customer, but for the staff themselves, actually, and helps them do task management with spatial tasks, which saves them time on handovers. But the really, really important feature was the ability to generate heat maps of where things are selling in the store, actually. Because every retailer in the world has a scarce resource, their shelf space. The computer game of retail ultimately boils down to what products should I carry, how much space should I give them, and where should I give them this space. And you may be surprised to know that most retailers basically don't know where their products are in the store. How could this be? Well, if we look at our customer as an example, this recent Northern European retailer, with 1,300 locations, each location has up to 30% of their assortment locally sourced. So headquarters has no way of making a unified map of all of that. And for the people that really try to be planogram compliant, where they make a map saying, here's where all the products should go, the result of that is they can only make a change to a shelf maybe once or twice a year. We learned that the main stakeholder of the planogram, this aspirational map of where products should go, is actually the analytics department. And using spatial computing, we could capture where are the products actually, and for the first time, they could see how their shelves are performing. And most of the stores that have come online literally found actionable insights the first time they sat down with the heat map. So XR for retail, yes. Multi-million dollar deals, yes. But it wasn't customer-facing navigation, as we suspected it would be. Then we partnered with the fantastic guys at Accurate. Accurate makes an AI solution that looks at the sales data generated by the retailers and makes predictive models about missed sales opportunities and sales blockers, things that may have gone wrong in the store. And this spatial data that Auki is generating is not only a captivating new dimension to analyze for Accurate, but also a way for Accurate's AI to collaborate with the human staff. Because now, Accurate's AI can send human staff or robots out to the specific place in the store where there's a suspected sales blocker, and the issue can be investigated. Interesting things happen when you make the physical world accessible to AI. And it turns out that when you make the physical world accessible to AI, it also becomes more accessible to human beings. We partnered with Zappar, some of the greatest people in the XR industry. Anyone in here knows them. They've been around for a long time. And they just developed this amazing new technology to use app clip AR so that you can do navigation without having to download an app. And we partnered together last year to make navigation for the blind and partially sighted. Which we can demo for you today downstairs. There's an app-free navigation solution running across the whole conference floor downstairs, powered by Auki and Zappar. And this is also now coming into thousands of locations to help the blind and the partially sighted do shopping independently. Interesting things happen when you make the physical world accessible to AI. Now, we're partnering with a fantastic quadriplegic hacker to make electric wheelchairs with full self-driving. He has a very unfortunate situation where because he can only control one hand to drive his electric wheelchair, that's the same hand that he uses to talk. So apart from sitting in a wheelchair, which can be limiting, he can't move and talk at the same time. Can't move and talk at the same time. But when you make the physical world accessible to AI, we can help the chair move on its own so that Steven can keep talking while he's moving. And also very exciting to us is our partnership with Mentra, a new smart glasses company that I bet many of you saw for the first time yesterday. Mentra is a newly funded company. They just raised $8 million through Y Combinator, and they have a very simple, brilliant idea about the future of glasses. They pointed out to us that, hey, glasses were invented 800 years ago, but it wasn't until 1920 that people started wearing them all day. How come? Well, in the 1920s, for the first time, material science made it possible to make glasses that weighed less than 40 grams. 800 years of history will tell us that human beings will not wear glasses all day if they weigh more than 40 grams. So what Caden and Alex and the guys at Mentra are doing is delivering exactly that. AI glasses that weigh under 40 grams. And today, downstairs, we are demoing spatial awareness with AI glasses weighing under 40 grams. When we make the physical world accessible to AI, a lot of amazing new opportunities open up. Apart from these partners that are with us here today, we are increasingly partnering with some of the greatest robotics companies in the world. We suspect that over the next just 2 to 3 years, we will have thousands, if not tens of thousands, of robots. Hey, Terry, how you doing? This is Terry, our humanoid resources intern. Hey, Terry. Terry is a Unitree G1. Unitree is a Chinese humanoid robotics company that are shipping humanoids today. You can buy this guy today. What's up with that, Elon? Unitree is one of several Chinese robotics companies that are building and shipping humanoids today. And apart from humanoids, there are many amazing special purpose robots like the ones from Padbot or SlamTech or Pudu Robotics, all of which we are integrating with our collaborative machine perception network now. We believe that Auki is going to roll into over 100,000 retail locations over the next 3 years, and that we will be the first software platform for collaborative machine perception running on tens of thousands of robots in the very, very near future. We are here together with our partners today, right at the entrance of the show floor. We have a bunch of demos that we'd love to show you, and we have a new grants program for builders. So if you want to build something with AI and spatial awareness, and you want to help make the world better by making the physical world accessible to AI, come see us, get a grant. Let's build something cool together. Thank you very much.